What is 45's cheating strategy to stay in office? A person says they recall seeing a memorable newspaper headline in February of 1974 when they were covering the British general election. The Conservative Party, led by the incumbent Prime Minister Edward Heath, had just lost its majority in Parliament. Because of a strong showing by smaller parties, no party was able to claim a majority after the election. The tradition in Britain is for the defeated Prime Minister to resign immediately after losing an election, but Heath, hesitated. The next day, the front page of a tabloid aligned with the opposition Labour Party showed a photo of Prime Minister Heath in front of number 10 Downing Street with the headline for the love of the invisible ferryman, go. He did a few days later. We may see that headline in the U.S. this fall if 45 loses a close election and refuses to concede. A year ago, 45 told a crowd that he might remain in office at least for 10 to 14 years. He tweeted that after serving two terms, no, we don't want you to stay longer. We want you to go as fast as possible. We don't want you in office any longer than what it is now. And technically, by law, he can't serve more than, he can't stay in office for 10 to 14 years because the Constitution has it written in that the president can only serve two terms and then they fucking go after serving. 45's dumbass son-in-law and senior White House House advisor Jared Dumbass Kushner has entertained the idea of postponing the election because of the coronavirus pandemic. The squatter has no authority to do this. The presumptive Democratic nominee Joe Biden warned, I think he is going to try to kick back the election somehow, come up with some rational why it can't be held. And 45 conceded, saying that the general election will be held November 3rd, but he added, I think a lot of people will cheat with the mail-in voting. Isn't that what you did already, you fucking dumbass? 45 is on a crusade to discredit voting by mail. Many states are adopting mail-in ballots as a way of protecting voters from infection. In the April 7th Wisconsin primary, 52 people who voted in person or worked at the polls tested positive for the COVID-19. The Democrats support mail-in balloting as a way of expanding the electorate to groups that normally don't turn out in large numbers but tend to favor Democrats like young people and minorities. 45 claims that mail-in voting can lead to voter fraud and thousands of fake ballots. The evidence, I think just some common sense tell you that massive manipulation can take place. The squatter has threatened to withhold government funds from Michigan and Nevada if those states carry out plans to send absentee ballots to voters. People cheat. Well, 45 knows all about cheating, so yeah. At the White House press briefing, mail ballots are a very dangerous thing for this country because they're cheaters. Yeah, we know you love to cheat. Yeah. Just what is 45 up to? Very likely a strategy of the squatter loses a state with mail-in balloting by a narrow margin. He won Michigan in 2016 by less than a quarter of a percent. He may go to court to claim fraud and block that state's electoral votes from being cast for Biden. It would have to be done very quickly. A large number of absentee ballots is likely to slow down the vote count, and the Electoral College must meet on December 14th. The case would most likely be expedited to the Supreme Court, which would have to issue a ruling by December 8th, 6 days before the Electoral College vote. 45 may believe that he commands a 5-4 conservative majority on the Supreme Court, but a victory in court is by no means assured. If no candidate wins a majority of the electoral vote, we have what is called a contingent election for squatter. That has only happened once before. In 1824, the House of Representatives would have to choose the squatter from the top three candidates in electoral college votes, and get this, each state would have one vote. Right now, 26 states have a Republican majority in the House, and 22 states have a Democratic majority. Two states have tied delegations. So a House vote by state would go to 45, right? Not so fast. The squatteral vote would be cast by the new House, which is elected in November 2020, not the current House, so who knows. The Constitution is clear on one point. The terms of the squatter and vice squatter shall end at noon on the 20th day of January following the election. What if the House can't produce a majority winner by January 20th of 2021? Then the vice squatter becomes the acting president. And then who becomes the vice president? The newly installed Senate would elect the vice president from the top two electoral vote winners. And what if the Senate fails to produce a vice squatter? Then the next in line for acting president would be the Speaker of the House. Would be the speaker of the new House of Representatives. Members of Congress would have to decide whether to vote in line with that party or their state. Voting by state would probably be fine, but 45 in 2016 he carried 30 out of the 50 states, which is still fucking amazes me how fucking stupid some of these people are. Currently, the polls show Biden ahead nationally and in all the swing states except North Carolina, since the 45 campaign can't rely on a booming economy anymore. It's relying on its 2016 strategy, immobilize the inbred base. That means demonizing Joe Biden the same way he demonized Hillary Clinton, and then heightening his base's resentment of the educated elite. 45's base is highly sensitive to condensation, i.e. people who call them deplorables or belittle voters who cling to guns or religion. 45's inbred base, mostly white voters who are KKK members and without a college degree, is not a majority. They were 1/3 of the voters in 2016, but they're strategically located in the battleground states. What the 45 campaign has to do is suppress Democratic turnout, hence the attack on mail-in voting. In 2016, polls showing Hillary Clinton as a near-certain winner helped 45. I heard voters all over the country say, I can't vote for 45 and I don't trust Hillary, but you know, she doesn't need my vote. If 45 loses the election, 45 will have an army of supporters. He can command them and harass the President Joe Biden from whatever post he chooses to occupy in the media. And don't forget, 45 can run for squatter again in 2024 when he will be the same age as Joe Biden is now. And technically, 45 doesn't need to run for office in 2024. We don't need him at all.